Hello and welcome to Achievers Academy. Today we are going to read the chapter Bholi, written by K.A. Abbas. Bholi. Her real name was Sulekha and she was the fourth daughter of Nambardar Ramlal. Ramlal's work is to collect tax from the village for the government. He had seven children, three sons and four daughters. And the youngest of them was Bholi. When she was 10 months old, she had fallen off the cot on her head and it had damaged some part of her brain. That's why she remained a backward child. At birth, Bholi was very fair and pretty. But when she was 2 years old, she had an attack of smallpox. The entire body was permanently disfigured by deep black pockmarks. She could not speak till she was 5, and when at last she learned to speak, she stammered. She talked very little because the other children often made fun of her and mimicked her. All the children except Bholi were healthy and strong. The sons had been sent to the city to study in schools and later in the colleges. Of the daughters, Radha the eldest and the second daughter Mangla had already been married, and the third daughter Champa. It was not difficult to find bridegroom for her because she was also good looking. But Ramlal was worried about Bholi. She had neither good looks nor intelligence. Bholi was 7 years old when Mangla was married, and the same year a primary school for girls was opened in their village. The Tehsildar came there to perform its opening ceremony or for its inauguration. He told Ramlal that he must send his daughters to school to set an example to the villagers. That night, when Ramlal consulted his wife, she cried, "Are you crazy? If girls go to school, who will marry them?" But Ramlal had not the courage to disobey the Tehsildar. At last, his wife said, "Send Bholi to school, because there is little chance of her getting married. Let the teachers at school worry about her." The next day, Ramlal caught Bholi by the hand and reached the school. Ramlal handed over his daughter to the headmistress. Bholi did not know what exactly a school was like and what happened there, but she was glad to find so many girls, almost of her own age. She hoped that one of these girls might become her friend. She finds her teacher very different from people at home. At home, nobody cares for her. Even her mother thinks her to be a burden. But her teacher shows great love and sympathy for her. She brought a new hope and filled her with confidence. Bholi's parents decided to marry her with a middle-aged person. When the man saw Bholi's face at the time of wedding, he laid down a condition. He said that he would marry only if he was given 5,000 rupees. Bholi's father had to give him money. But now, Bholi refused to marry such a greedy man. She threw the garland into the fire and got up. Now, Bholi's father told her that nobody else would marry her. At this, Bholi said that she would look after her parents in their old age, and she said that she would teach in the school where she had learned so much. So, moral of the story, girls are in no way less helpful than boys to their parents. That's all. See you in my next video. Goodbye.